Abilene, Texas. Go ahead, please.
Yes, Christopher, you seem like a nice young man. You really do, but you're terribly naive when it comes to this, because here in Texas, we know what's going on. Our governor has been in cahoots with Cintra, which is a Spanish company, to build this highway for years and years, and it is happening. Here in Texas, we happen to love our land, and they are going to start imminent domain proceedings very soon now to take a 500,000 acres of the best farmland on earth, not to mention disrupting the cities across our state. This is very real, and America had better wake up. And as far as having Mexican trucks coming into our country, we should be scared to death, because this is just the beginning. There is no will in Washington to close this border. But here in Texas, to think that there's going to be a superhighway owned by a Spanish company with proceeds from the tolls going to a foreign country, it'll be a limited access. You won't be getting on it in the family car. It'll be mostly for commerce from Mexico. And it's happening, and for you to just say that it isn't going to happen. Our Governor Perry is a protege of the president. And all of this, they claim, is just an extension of the NAFTA, the Free Trade Agreement. But it's more than that. And when you talk about the meeting in Montebello being secret, doesn't that concern you?
It does, yeah. I mean, let me just be clear. Half of the article, I spent several weeks in Texas, and half the article is devoted to exactly the things that you've said. And I want to make it crystal clear, the Trans-Texas Corridor is a very real project. It's very worrying for a lot of reasons. The eminent domain issues you mentioned, which are in the article, the fact that 500,000 acres of land can be taken, the fact that it is going to be this novel and privatized version of an public infrastructure project in which toll revenue is going to be extracted by a private corporation is incredibly worrying. The means by which it's been pushed through with very little oversight, the fact that the Governor Perry, as you noted, vetoed, despite the fact that both houses passed a moratorium on TTC, the governor vetoed it because he's so devoted to the project, despite the fact that if you poll Texans, they don't want it. So I want to be very clear, the Trans-Texas Corridor is very real. I think it's very worrisome. I think there's a lot of very legitimate and good reasons that people are organizing in opposition to it, some of which you mentioned. So I just want to make clear that I'm not trying to discount the existence of the Trans-Texas Corridor at all.
But it goes along the lines of what you wrote about, is that there's those elements of reality and those elements that where people are painting what's going on to what could happen.
That's right. Exactly. Right. So that's where the distinction is, essentially. I mean, the Trans-Texas Corridor is real, but there's no evidence that it is part of any coordinated effort to get something like this built across the heartland of the country.
Poplar.